On Wednesday, Facebook announced technologies to help users take the social experience they know on Facebook out into other places on the web. The Open Graph API and Open Graph Protocol will allow Facebook and participating websites to use social information to customize each visitor's experience. For example, if you stated a preference on Facebook for a certain kind of music or food, another site could use that information to highlight certain content.
Today, the web exists mostly as a series of unstructured links between pages, and this has been a powerful model, but it's really just the start. The Open Graph puts people at the center of the web.
Another step toward making a Facebook-like social experience more ubiquitous on the web is allowing other users to include iframe plugins, such as a simple like button for users to tell their Facebook friends what they've enjoyed. This makes life easier for both developers and users, compared with more complicated methods used now for sharing links on Facebook.
I'm personally extremely excited that as of today, there's going to be a like button on every movie page on IMDb. So if I visit The Godfather on IMDb and I click like, it's going to go to my Facebook stream, just like shares do today. But the IMDb is using the Open Graph protocol, so they've marked up their pages. We know this isn't just any old web page. This represents a movie with the name Godfather, made in 1972. And because of that, this page is also going to go in the movies section of my profile.
At a press conference following the keynote, Facebook executives said none of the changes would affect users' privacy, an issue often raised in relation to Facebook.
Probably the most that they're going to experience are going to be social plugins, right? These pieces of functionality that people drop into their sites that make it so that you can see which of your friends have liked something or activity on a site. And that shows no new information to anyone than was previously visible, right? So, I mean, you could have seen those stories on newsfeed from your friends, but instead on CNN, for example, now you can see only the part of the newsfeed filtered down to the stuff relevant to CNN. So it really has no privacy implications at all.
Facebook has also eliminated a policy that partners couldn't cache personal information for more than 24 hours. Executives said that this change also won't affect users' privacy.
I just want to emphasize that that policy is really a removal of a technical restriction, but it doesn't change the restrictions we have on what partners can do with user data.
Third-party developers at the conference welcome the new developments.
This is great for brands because there's not a lot of social context available through brand websites, whether you're a publisher or a product company. So by putting the Facebook Open Graph API onto your site, you immediately have social context of your site without having to build everything out.
The Facebook API is already active on several partner websites, including Pandora, The New York Times, and CNN. With reporting by Steve Lawson and Juan Carlos Perez, I'm Justin Meisinger, IDG News Service.